Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to study one of the important topic, that is ethics to be followed by the retailer. So in every subject, this concept ethics is very important. Remember. Now let's begin. Ethics to be followed by the retailer. What are the ethics? Ethics means what is wrong, what is right, right? What is right and what is wrong, that you have to know even as a citizen, what to do and what not to do. That is nothing but ethics. As a retailer, what to do and what not to do, what is right, what is wrong, that retailer should know before doing business, right? So ethics to be followed by the retailer. Now ethics is a branch of philosophy that deals with the values relating to the human conduct with respect to right or good and wrong or bad actions. Here ethics relates to retailers' moral principles and values. Ethics is derived from the Greek word that is ethos, which means character. So ethics in retailing pose certain critical issues. Retailing plays a vital role in the economy. The retail industry is the first link in the distribution chain from the customer's point of view. It is therefore vital for retailers to act in an ethical manner because they affect the lives of the many people. So now as a retailer, what is ethics? Ethics is nothing but moral principle or the character or we can say what to do and what not to do. Okay, now as a retailer, what he can do and what he should not do, that is nothing but ethics. That ethics need to be followed by the retailer. Clear? So say ethical practice towards the consumers. Now what are the ethical practice towards the consumer? The retailer should charge fair price to the customers, right? That is the first ethics, in the sense fair price or reasonable price that they have to charge. Then another one, quality products they have to supply, right? The consumers have to get correct and right to precise knowledge about the product sold to them in usage, ingredients, etc. Okay, see, one is reasonable price they have to charge, then quality products they have to provide, then proper information about the ingredients or the items that that they have used in that particular product, each and every information that they need to provide to the consumer, right? Then regarding guarantee, then warranty and guarantee, then price, these are the information or these are the ethical practices as a retailers they need to practice. Ethical business is essential in competitive and dynamic environment. Now what are the ethical points as a retailer should do to the consumers? One is fair price, then fair quality, then warranty, guarantee issues, then proper information they need to supply regarding ingredients that they have used in that particular product, each and every information they need to supply to the consumers. That is nothing but ethical practice towards the consumers. Clear? Then next is ethical practice towards the investors or shareholders. Now who is the investor? Investor is nothing but the real owners of the company. Shareholders are the owners of the business. Shareholders must be given fair returns on their investment at a regular intervals. In the sense, the shareholders are the real owners of the company, and the importance should be given to the shareholders because they are the real owners. So the proper return should be given to the shareholders. So that is the responsibility of the retailer. So as far as retail industry is concerned, distribute the shares to the public, right? What is the responsibility of the retail industry? The proper return to the shareholders in the form of dividend they need to provide. Clear? That is the ethical practice towards the investors and shareholders. Along with that, they need to call for inform the shareholders to participate in the meetings. especially writing votes should be given, then all these that advantages of shareholders are there, right? So all those points you can include in this particular point, that is ethical practice towards the investors and shareholders. Clear? Then next is ethical practice towards the employees. Now, what are the ethical practice should be done by the retailer to the employees? One, the proper salary, right? Then systematic way of recruitment, selection and training, then promotional methods, then welfare facilities. All those are the ethical practices towards the employees. So what are that? See, ethical practices must also be followed by towards the employees. The retail industry employs large volume of retail staff. Therefore, proper policies and procedures must be framed for the employees regarding recruitment, selection, training, promotion, welfare, etc. Negative issues relating to employment relations in the workplace can lead to loss of reputation and customers. It leads to the poor staff morale, low productivity, high labor turnover. To avoid these confrontations, the retailer manager should follow the ethical practices toward the employees. See, if the retailer is not going to treat the employees properly, then these, you can see the labor turnover, in the sense the staff, retail staff are going to leave your retail store and they join some other retail shop, because that is nothing but labor turnover. Is it clear? Because if you don't treat well, definitely they find the alternative job. So that is one negative. Then what are the ethical practices as a retailer should practice? One, they need to provide a proper salary, then proper systematic way of recruitment, selection and training, along with that proper promotion methods, then welfare measures, clear? Welfare measures like hospital, then education, all those things that should be provided to the employees. So this is about ethical practices towards the employees. So this is about ethics to be followed by the retailer. Hope you are clear. Ethical practices or ethics to be followed by the retailer. Thank you.